Healthcare is one of the main talking points for Democratic candidates eyeing the White House in 2020.
Some of the top candidates are pitching healthcare for all, but a member of Utah's congressional delegation says it's not what most Americans want.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Last week, the House Budget Committee took up a report from the Congressional Budget Office, or CBO, on Medicare for All. Utah Representative Chris Stewart sits on that committee. He says the numbers are out of reach.
You know, depending on the estimate, as much as $32 trillion. And that sounds like so much money. Most people have no idea what that even means. But then you explain it this way. It means every American taxpayer and every American business has their taxes doubled, and it still doesn't quite pay for it.
He also says a single-payer system removes consumer choice when most want to stay where they are.
It takes away their private insurance. It takes away the options they now have, and it compels them onto a government program.
Utah Health Policy Project is an organization dedicated to increasing access for health care. They are not taking a position on Medicare for All, but
we clearly do have an access problem in Utah.
Courtney Bullard says 10% of Utah adults are uninsured, and 7% of children are uninsured in our state. A 20% increase on the children's rate from last year.
So a lot of these kids who are eligible for services, for coverage, their parents are uninsured, and so they go uninsured even though they are eligible. And so increasing that 10% uninsured adult rate is really going to have effects on the child's uninsured rate as well.
She says Utahns clearly favor that after approving Medicaid expansion in November. Stewart says his goal is to increase access too, but insists there's a better way than Medicare for All.
But we can fix this without tearing down a system that has served Americans for generations. You fix it through expanding CHIP, for example. You fix it through driving down costs.
Stewart says it's also crucial to protect patients with pre-existing conditions. We do have a link to that full CBO report for you. It's on our website, abc4.com.